Hi, this video is on using spreadsheet formulas to calculate compound interest. And you know you can get this worksheet on my website if you need it at caroleemath.com. I'm going to introduce you to the formulas and kind of how spreadsheets work, because you might not be familiar with spreadsheets at all. If you are, that's great. If you're not, it's not a prerequisite for this class. Okay, so I'm going to show you two different formulas, future value and present value, and just explain what all of the inputs are. So you will need access to either Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets while you're watching these videos so that you can practice. You can also use the Google Sheets app on your phone. You can use the Microsoft Excel app on your phone, but you have to log in, you have to have an account. So I prefer to use the Google Sheets app because I don't have to log in. So just to orient you, let me show you. I'm going to use my phone, but you can use a computer or a tablet. I'm using my phone because it's easier for the videos because I can use the document camera in the phone more easily. Okay, so I have a working phone. Google Sheets, I put it on my home screen here, so it's real fast for me to find it. You could also use the Google Drive app, but then you have to go to Sheets from the Drive. So Sheets gets there faster. So I click on that. I've been playing around. I have some other things that people have sent me. My son is texting me. Good timing. So I'm going to add, just to start a new spreadsheet. Sorry, you couldn't see that at the bottom. Let me go back. I push the add button right there and new spreadsheet. Okay, so this gives me a blank spreadsheet. I'm going to just make it bigger so we can all see what we're doing. I'm really only going to use one cell at a time because I'm going to be putting in this formula. Okay, and I just want to give you the context here. So what we'll be doing is typing in equals FV equals, just takes a little practice, FV, and when I hit parentheses, it tells me all the inputs. So this is a function that calculates a future value. So if I want to put some money in now, and I've got an interest rate, and I've got a certain number of compounding periods, then I can put all those inputs into this function, and it will tell me the future value, the value out in the future. So you don't have to memorize any of these formulas. I don't have them memorized because when I go into Excel or Google Sheets, it tells me what they are. We just need to know how to use them and when to use each formula. Okay, so we'll come back to this after defining what all of these things are. The other formula is the present value formula. So that is a formula that says, I want to know how much I need to put in now to get something later. So present value is what you need to put in now. Future value is what you get out in the future. Make sense? Okay, so the rate, both of these, I'm doing them at the same time because they have very similar inputs. In fact, most of the same inputs. So the rate is the interest rate. In decimal form, just how you saw in the last video that we were changing our interest rate into decimal form. 6% is 0.06. And I also need to add that this is per period. So for example, if we're compounding monthly, we need to divide it by 12. So that per period is very important. And we'll go through lots of examples of this. N per is the number of periods, number of compounding periods. So just as an example from what we were doing in the last video, I gave the example of compounding monthly. The per period, that would be 0.06 divided by 12 for monthly. And then we would need to take however many years times 12, and that would give us the number of compounding periods. So we can do all this right inside of our formula. Okay, payment is, well, let me just write out that PMT stands for payment. This is in a situation where you're going to be making regular monthly payments, or regular periodic payments, could be quarterly, yearly, monthly. We won't always use this, it could be zero. In the case, like the example we were doing before with the simple and compound interest, we were just putting a beginning amount in and we were not adding any money regularly to the account. So in this case, our payment would be zero. So this is amount of regular payments. Has to also be the same number every time. If any. So use a zero if none. But it is very important to put that zero in there because that the spreadsheet is expecting a number there. If we skip it, then it will take that number and think it's that number. So it's very important to have the zero in there. We need any number in there as a placeholder. Okay, PV is the present value. PV stands for present value. That is the value of the money right now. Okay, so it's your initial deposit. You could think of it as the principal or the value right now. Depending on the context, either one of those might make sense. FV is the future value. That is the value out then. So it could be how much money am I going to have at the end? Value or balance. In the future. So this is what you want to have at the end, whatever your time period is. If it's a loan, you want it to be zero at the end. So that whatever the value or balance is in the future. Okay, you notice that some of these arguments or inputs have square brackets around them. So the brackets mean optional. Meaning, if you just did the first three, it would just ignore, it would treat those as zeros. Just ignore those. Same thing over here. So the bracket just tells you those are optional inputs. We'll be using the first one, two, three, four. These are different depending on which scenario we have. The type we're really not going to use. It has to do with whether the payment is made or comes in at the beginning or the end of the period, like the beginning of the month or the end of the month. If you take accounting, I'm sure you'll get into this in more thoroughly, but for our purposes, we're not really going to make a distinction between the end and the beginning of the period. So this is optional. The payment at the beginning or end of the period. So for our purposes, we're going to skip this one. Okay, so now we have our what all these inputs mean in the formulas. Okay, so now let's practice using them, and we'll do that in the next video. Okay, so I'll see you there.